And I would also like to appreciate the fact that the timing of this meeting, we are all politicians and we know that timing in different situations is very important. And given the behavior of the European Union during the days of uprising in Iran, it's very important that we are holding this meeting now. And I really think, as it is up to now, that we should be speaking simple, plain language, and this should not be the exercise in eloquency. The people of Iran, especially the young generation, showed clearly that they want a regime change and that they have had enough of this Islamic fundamentalist rule. During the days of demonstration, many of them shouted, "Down with the dictator, down with Khamenei and Rouhani." It was interesting that also they shouted against the Iran's participation in war in Syria. As we all know, Bashar Assad in Syria has been in power also thanks to Iranian regime backing together with Russia. But the point I wanted to question today is about the role of Europe or European Union. What was actually the response of EU to this uprising? I'm sad to say, I'm using the word sad, some of the previous speakers also use this word, that EU response was very big disappointment for the people in Iran and for us, to say the best. It took Madame Mogherini long 5 days to write a tweet concerning the uprising in Iran, and it still insisted to keep in close contacts with the government of Rouhani. Sorry to say, but it shows how much some of our colleagues are divorced from reality, from the real situation in Iran. The Iranian people expected EU to help them about internet, about the communications, as the regime closed down internet and heavily filtered several popular applications. The people of Iran, expected Europe to strongly react to the news of the detainees being killed under torture, and there was no response. I guess that the Iranian people expected Europe to react when the protesters were killed by direct fire by the Revolutionary Guards during the dozens were killed. Unfortunately, EU was silent. I think that this is a wrong policy, morally, politically, and for our long-term interest in Iran. Mrs. Mariam Rajavi, who recently visited the Council of Europe, has asked that question: where is Europe's commitment to human rights? I'm afraid again that she will have to wait for some time to get the right and real answer. I'm afraid that we don't have that answer now. And I'm sure that when mullahs are gone and Iran would be free again, the people of Iran will back, they have memory, political memory, and remember those who were standing by them. And that is why we as parliamentarians, as elected representatives of the European people, must really stand with those brave young protesters who demonstrated in 142 cities in Iran. I think it is our duty. Thank you very much.